So good morning, dear student. So in the last class, I discussed about trigonometry ratios of some specific angles. In the last class, already I discussed how to find the trigonometry ratios of value of 45 degree and 30 and 60 degree. And then I also sent one table and I told today I am going to show you how to remember or how to make that table. The table is very important, you have to remember it. But how to remember that table, today I will show you. So let's see the table. So the table I have given, say this one. It was here 0 degree, then 30, 45, 60, and then 90 degree. And the first one is the value for sine, trigonometric ratio, sine. Sine 0 degree, I told the value is 0. Then it is 1 by 2, 30 degree, 45, 1 by root 2, and 60 degrees, root 3 by 2, 90 degrees, 1. So how to remember this first line? If you know the first line, then other all we can find out very easily. Let's see how to remember this first line. I show you here. So the first line, it will be start from 0, 0 degree. Then you write 1, then for this 2, then for this 3, then for this 4. Last value is 4. Divide all the number by 4 now. And then you give one square root. Now see, 0 by 4, square root of 0 by 4 is 0, square root of 1 by 4, and square root of 0 is 0 only. You can write it is 0, 0 by 4 is 0, square root of 0 is 0, square root of 1 by 4, square root of 1 is 1, square root of 4 is 2. You can cancel it. So square root of 1 is 1, square root of 2, it will be only square root, it is not perfect square number. Square root 3, but square root of 4 is 2, it is cancel 1, square root of 1 is 1. So these are the values for sine, say 0, 30 is up, 45 1 by root 2, 60 root 3 by 2, 90 is 1. This is the way how to remember, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Last value 4 divided by 1 by 4 and then give square root. So after getting this first one sine, cos now. Cos will be, see how to generate cos now. Cos will be reverse value of sine. This 1 90 degree will come here. Then root 3 by 2. Then 1 by root 2. Then half. Then 0. This is the value of cos. Then it's 10. You remember 10 is actually sine divided by cos. Sine divided by cos. Actually, why say 10 is, we know 10 any angle, suppose I get A, we know 10 is what? P by B. Turn permanently black. P by B. So now if P divided by 10, B is also divided by H, both means divided by H, then P by H, you know, sine. Some people have B by H is cos. So that is ultimately chain equal to sine by cos. So sine divided by cos. So sine 0 divided by 1, it will be 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, 2 to cancel, 1 by root 3. Then it is 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2, cancel 1. Root 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2, 2 to cancel, root 3 by 1, root 3, and 1 by 0. So anything divided by 0 is called undefined, not defined. That is, you can say the symbol is infinity. Symbol is infinity, or you can say not defined. Now after getting this 3, Other three you can find very easily. Now I write cot. What is the reciprocal of 10? So here it is, nothing means 1 is the denominator. So if I reciprocate it, 1 by 0. So 1 by 0 is undefined because anything divided by 0, then it is 1 by root 3. The cot will be root 3 by 1. It is 1 reciprocal of 1, here 1 by 1, 1. Here root 3 divided by 1, so 1 by root 3. And infinity here, 1 is there. If I reciprocate it, it will be 0. Because see, something divided by 0, like 1 by 0, I got infinity. So if I change their place, these two place, 1 by infinity equal to 1 again, 0. Therefore, if I reciprocate infinity, then I will get again 0. Then see, after cot, then sec. Sec is the reciprocal of cos. So it is 1, denominator nothing is 1, 1 by 1, 1. Then root 3 by 2, 2 by root 3, reciprocal. It is 1 by root 2, reciprocal root 2 by 1. 1 by 2, root 1 by 2, reciprocal 2 by 1, 2. 0, by 1 is there, so 1 by 0 is undefined, infinity. There is cosec. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine, reciprocal it. Nothing means here 1, to 1 by 0, infinity, 1 by 2, reciprocal 2 by 1, 2, 1 by root 2, reciprocal root 2 by 1, root 3 by 2, reciprocal 2 by root 3, and 1 by 1, reciprocal is 1. This is the way how to remember this table. So, this table you have to write one or two times, so you just write it by your own. So after that, we can do the sum very easily. But before that, we have to remember this table. So hope you understand how to remember this table. So now we are moving to do the application part. So how to use this table? So let's see. Exercise 8.2. Exercise 8.2. See, evaluate the following. Question number 1, number 1 is given. Sine 60 degree, then cos 30 degree, plus sine 30, cos 60. So, how to evaluate or find the value? Let's see. Here just we have to put the value. The value of sine 60 is just now I shown you in the table. So you just follow the table. Root 3 by 2. And cos 30 is also root 3 by 2. You can see the table. Sine 30 is half. Into is here. Cos 60 is again half. So now simplify. 2 to the 4. Denominator, denominator multiply. Root 3 into root 3. 3. Plus 2 to the 4, 1 into 1, 1, 4 is the LCM, 3 plus 1, 4 by 4, so answer is 1. This is the first one. So, first the sums are very easy sum. Now see the next one. So, these are application of that table actually. Let's see. I just would like to recall one thing. See, I told you if it is like cos square A, angle is A, that is the meaning is cos A whole square. Cos A whole square. It is cos A whole square means don't write cos A square. Not A square. Angle is same. A only. Cos square means it is actually cos A into cos A. Cos A into cos A. Or you can say cos A whole square. Don't form this one, don't write this one. Not this one actually. This is not correct. So, you have to remember cos square A or maybe 10 square A, 10 A whole square A. Means I actually want to say If it is given sin square 45 degree, so you have to write it sin 45 then whole square. The angle is as it is. Just trigonometric ratio will be twice. Sin 45, sin 45. So now see. The next question is given number 2. Same, evaluate twice. 10 square 45 degree plus cos square 30 degree plus, sorry, minus sin square 60 degree. So this one you can write 10 45 actually whole square. You can write one by more. Cos square 30 means you can write cos 30 whole square, and sin square 60 you can write sin 60 degree whole square. Now you can put the value. What is the value of 10 45? You can see from the table it is 1 square is here. The value of cos 30 root 3 by 2 whole square is here. The value of sin 60 root 3 by 2, then outside 1 square is here. So that is 2 into 1 square is 1 plus root 3 square is 3, 2 square 4 minus root 3 square 3, 2 square 4, both square. So this is plus 3 by 4 minus 3 by 4, 2 under, the answer is 2. So this is very easy sum. Now see the next one, number 3. So one by one we will do the sum then. Slowly, slowly, a difficult sum will come. Let's see number 3. Number 3 will be a little bit of, not difficult, you have to do the calculation here. Since rationalize the denominator will come again. Sec 30 plus cosec 30. Now you just see the table. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2. Then sec 30. Sec 30. You just recall cos 30. Once you got cos 30, sec 30 will be reciprocal of cos. Cos 30 we know root 3 by 2. So therefore sec 30 will be 1. Reciprocal, because sec is reciprocal of cos. So it is 2 by root 3 plus cosec 30. You just recall sin 30. Sin 30 is up. So cosec is the reciprocal of sin. Cosec 30 will be 2 by 1, that is 2. So here it is 2. Now see, how to simplify this one. So we have to take the LCM. It is 1 by root 2. Here root 3 and 1, the LCM will be root 3. So it is like cross multiply, 2 into 1, 2 plus 2 into root 3, 2 root 3. Now this divided by this. So what I'll do, I'll write them in multiplication form. This side unit. Now see, I'll do here. This is 1 by root 2 divided by this. So that is 1 by, if I write multiply, it will be reciprocal. Root 3 divided by 2 plus 2 root 3. So that is, this multiply, 2 plus 2 root 3 and 1 into root 3 root 3. So that means a little bit of calculation you have to do here. So you already know this thing you got in class 9, how to multiply this time the rational number. 2 into root 2, 2 root 2. I just want to recall again, see how to multiply. See, if it is 2 root 2 into 3 root 5, then multiplies outside, outside multiply, 3 into 2, 6, and inside root multiplies, 2 into 5, 10. You cannot multiply 3 and inside root 2. Outside, outside, inside, inside. That's why here we see root 2 and 2. Here outside is 1, so 2, 1 is 2. Here root, but here no root, so it will be as it is. That's why 2 root 2. Here, see this one, root 2 into 2 root 3. So here outside is 1, so 2 into 1, 2, root 2, root 3 multiplied by root 6. You have to follow this to root 6, and here it is root 3. Now, here a little bit of calculation again you have to do, otherwise you will not get full mark. So that is rationalizing the denominator, which you got in plus 9, because denominator is not rational, the root is there. 2 root 2 plus 2 root 6. 2 root 6. So this is like a plus b. I'll multiply them. A minus b. So same thing we have to multiply in the numerator also, that is this one. 2 root 2 minus 2 root 6. Now let's see what we do. So this is like a plus b, a minus b. So that is a square minus b square, 2 root 6 whole square. And here you multiply this one, it is outside 1, 2, 1, 2, root 2, root 3, root 6, minus 2, 1, 2, root 6, root 3, root 18. So this is now, see how to multiply root 2 root 2 whole square. 2 root 2 whole square means the meaning is you have 2 root 2 into 2 root 2. So outside 2 2's are 4 and root 2 into root 2 you can say root 4. So root 4 is actually what? 2. So that is 8. So when root 2 and root 2 multiply, simply you can say 2. So 2 2's are 4, root 2 root 2 2, 4 into 2, 8. So it is come like this. So this thing you have to again recall. So that is, you can say this is 2 square 4, root 2 square 2, 8. 2 square 4 and root 6 square 6. 4 into 6, 24. And this is 2 root 6 minus 2. Now 18, see root 18 you can write. 18 means I can write root 18. 3, 3, 2. Prime factorization. This 3 will come out. 3, 3, 9 perfect square numbers. So that is into root 18 is 3 root 2. So that is 8 minus 24, that is minus 16. So it is 2 root 6 minus 2, 3 is 6 root 2. So 1, 2 will come out from here. 6 and 2, 2 common, root 6 minus 3 root 2 divided by minus 16. 1, 2, 2 cancel, 2, 8 is 16. That is, ultimately I will get here 6 minus 3 root 2 divided by minus 6. This minus you can write in the numerator again, because standard form minus we have to write in the numerator always. So minus here, so bracket will be root 6 minus 3 root 2. So that is 8. If you open the bracket, minus root 6 minus minus plus 3 root 2. So that is, you can say 3 root 2 first, plus is here, then minus root 6 by 8. This is the answer. So always you try to rationalize the denominator. Now see, denominator is the rational number. Hope you understand. Then question number 4 you have to do. I'll show you question number 5. Question number 5, see, it is given 5 cos square 60 degree plus 4 6 square 30 degree and minus 10 square 45 degree divided by sin square 30 plus cos square 30. So now we are going to put here the value. Sin sin square 30 means you can say sin 30 whole square. So value of sin 30 is 1 by 2 then whole square. Cos 30, it is actually cos 30 whole square. No need to write again, just cos 30 value right, root 3 by 2 then whole square is there, whole square. 5, cos square 60 means cos 60 half, whole square is there. 4, sec 30. So you know cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So sec will be reciprocal 2 by root 3. 2 by root 3 whole square. Then minus 10 square 45. 10 45 is 1. So 1 square. So now we have to just simplify. You put the value, this 1 by 2 whole square is 1 by 4 plus root 3 square is 3, 2 square is 4, then 5 into 1 by 2 whole square, that is 1 by 4 plus 4 into 2 square 4 and root 3 square is 3 minus 1 square is 1. So now see, the numerator is 5 into 1 by 4 means 5 ones are 5. Here denominator nothing means 1, 1 into 4 4. So 5 by 4 plus it is 1 here, 4 4s are 16 by 3. Then it is minus 1. And here if I take 4 is that same, 4 4 is same, 1 plus 3. So that is 4 by 4, it is 1, and 5 by 4 plus 16 by 3 minus 1. No need to write this denominator because it is 1. So 5 by 4 plus 16 by 3 minus 1. So now take the LCM, 3 and 4 LCM will be 12. So 4 3 is 3 5 is 15 plus 3 4 is 4 into 16, 64 minus 1, 12, 12, 1 is 12. So that is, these two are plus, sorry, these two are plus, 64 plus 15, 9, 79 minus 12. So that is, it is 12, 9 minus 2, 7, and 7 minus 1, 67 by 12. So, calculation you just check once again by your own, and if I have done any mistake then obviously you just remember one thing, that's it. Chances there that I can make some mistake, it's a human error. So when if I do any mistake, please show me that mistake, dear students. So I always try my level best, but if sometimes some calculation mistake is there, you just show me, sir, that calculation is, you have done some mistake. Okay, this answer is now 67 by 12. So, hope you understand. These four sum I have done, and another one sum I'll send it in the PDF. And question number 4 you have to do by your own, problem number 4. And one or two questions I can give you from me and mine. Thank you.